this 4,000 to 5,000-year-old stone circle on Salisbury Plain in southern England is a scheduled monument, UNESCO World Heritage Site, global tourist attraction, mystery in a lot of ways, and seed of endless conspiracy theories. Missing from the stock footage of Stonehenge is the nearby A303, just over 200 metres from the stones. This section is a notorious bottleneck on a national trunk road linking London to southwestern England, being the first single carriageway section heading away from London. In summer, the road is particularly jammed with holiday traffic from London heading to Devon and Cornwall, as well as to Stonehenge itself. Nobody is happy with this situation, so National Highways are planning to widen 13 kilometres of the A303 to a high-quality dual carriageway, featuring a new 3.2-kilometre bored tunnel under the site, hiding it from Stonehenge. While supported by the National Trust and English Heritage, who manage the site, this remains controversial. In 2021, a legal challenge was upheld, crowdfunded by campaign organisation Save Stonehenge World Heritage Site, putting the project on hold. That was until the 14th of July this year, when the challenge was overturned and it was announced that the project was going ahead again. This isn't the first time the tunnel has been proposed and then cancelled and proposed again over the past several decades. So, how did we get here? Nobody really knows how old this road is. It's believed to be roughly as old as Stonehenge itself. By Saxon times, it became known as Harrow Way. At the start of the 19th century, the new direct road was developed along the route by William Hanning, who planned to run early steam-powered coaches along it between London and Exeter. It's unclear whether he ever did, but horse-drawn coaches ran the route until railways took off decades later. In the 1920s, the Ministry of Transport first set about numbering roads. As their main route from London to the southwest, they nominated the A30, passing through Salisbury, Yeovil, basically every town and village along the way. Not long after, they realised the error of sending growing amounts of long-distance traffic through the middle of every town, so in 1933 created the A303 on the route of the old New Direct Road as a northern bypass of the A30. Since the 1960s, the A303 has slowly been upgraded piece by piece, a dualling here, a bypass there. The section of the A303 past Stonehenge hasn't yet been improved, because nobody can really agree on whether to or how. This is, in engineering terms, fairly unchallenging terrain, so you could just lay down another carriageway, which nobody wants past Stonehenge. In 1993, the government proposed several bypass options, which nobody liked, and also the first proposed tunnel. This would be very expensive, at the time £44 million, but have the benefit of hiding the road and thereby getting some support. Originally, this was to be a bored tunnel, drilled using tunnel boring machines to leave the surface undisturbed, but this was altered in 1999 to a cut and cover tunnel to save cost. Everyone hated the idea of digging a huge trench, and it was changed back to a bored tunnel in 2002. This was argued about until 2005, when the projected cost reached £470 million, and it was cancelled. 3 months later, it was resurrected, and 2 years later, in 2009, cancelled again, with the projected cost now £540 million. In 2012, the A344 was removed, which was within touching distance of Stonehenge, and 100 years ago was the main road. A new visitor centre was also built a few kilometres away, with a shuttle bus to Stonehenge along the former A344. In 2017, the government announced they were going ahead with the tunnel plan again. The budget this time was £1.6 billion, more than double the previous budget, even accounting for inflation, with work expected to start in 2021. Then, in 2021, came the legal challenge, and the High Court ruled that planning permission being given to the project was unlawful, and that proper consideration hadn't been given to the effects of the scheme and alternatives to it. This was after UNESCO implied that Stonehenge might lose World Heritage status if the tunnel went ahead. Then, yesterday, it was announced that the tunnel is going ahead after all. This was a total surprise to me and caused yet another rewrite of this script. I thought the project was going to be kicked into the long grass once again. Numerous economic events have happened since early 2020, and now the government is keen to save money. Elsewhere on the A303, though, work is progressing. The Sparkford to Orchester improvement is underway, upgrading another section to that not-quite-motorway standard Britain does so much. As the quality of the rest of the A303 improves, pressure on the Stonehenge section will only increase. The A303 is possibly the oldest, and certainly one of the most controversial roads in the UK. Much of the support for the scheme is based on the idea of removing or hiding the road from Stonehenge, but at the cost of hiding Stonehenge from the road. It should be considered that the road is perhaps as old as Stonehenge, and the builders of Stonehenge may have wanted it to be seen by passing travellers. Will work now actually start? Will it be cancelled or put on hold once again? I won't believe it until the diggers start arriving. Let me know what you think in the comments. Please consider subscribing if you want to see more things I've looked at. I got rather sunburnt making this video and suspect nobody will watch it, so if you can hear me say this, then please click something. I'm Martina and thank you for looking at things with me.